FELA, the hit musical, has captivated audience across the globe. It's the most acclaimed musical of the season and received 3 Tony Awards. Cast member Melanie Marshall joins us today. Melanie, we thank you for being with us. It's such a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, this show sounds fantastic.
It is. It's very, very exhilarating, very exciting. You're going to go through every single emotion. You're going to have a good time. You're going to sing. You're going to dance. You're probably going to cry a little bit, but you're going to have a good time.
I would imagine so. Let's start with just the topic of the show,
yes.
FELA.
Yes.
And give us a little background into who he was. He was the voice of disenfranchised people in his native Nigeria.
That's right.
And kind of created a global outcry.
Yes, he did. FELA Anikalapo Kuti, which is very, very hard to say on a good day.
I'll let you say
was a Nigerian singer, songwriter, political activist. And he created this amazing music called Afrobeat. Mm-hmm. And everything that he wanted to say about anything, he put in song. And his mantra was, music is the weapon. Everything that he wanted to do, everything that he wanted to say about his Nigerian people, for his Nigerian people, against the government, against all authorities, big, huge corporations, he put in song. And so the whole show, as much as we possibly can fit into 2.5 hours, is all about that. And his relationship, his special relationship with his mother, who was also a political activist in her own right, which is a role that I play, Fumilayo. And we span, the show is taken up after his mother's death. She died a very horrible death after 3 weeks of being thrown out of a two-story window by the authorities. Mm. And so this is the final concert that FELA wants to play before he decides he's going to leave Nigeria. Hmm. So as you come into the theater, you're going to be part of the shrine, which is still standing today in Nigeria. The shrine was FELA's nightclub, as it were. It's where you came after your day's work or wherever, and you wanted to just chill and just sit down or stand up and have some great music, have some great atmosphere, but also listen to the lyrics as to what he was talking about. What is he going to be complaining about today? What is he going to be writing about today? What's in that song?
So he really used music to evoke change.
Every single thing that he wanted to say, he put in song.
Hmm. I love it. Mm. Already.
Yes.
I got to see it. Let's talk about your role.
Okay.
Who do you play?
I play Fumilayo, which is FELA's mother. Okay. A very strong, stern political activist, feminist, who instilled in her son all of her political views and stances and everything that she wanted to do, everything that she felt that her son should do in politics, she instilled in him. Hmm. So far that, you know, sometimes you know what it's like with them, with children. They have to suck it and see. So instead of just thinking, okay, well, I understand that's what you're saying, mother, so therefore that's what it is. No. He had to leave Nigeria. He had to go to LA. He had to see for himself. He had to see things in the world for himself to realize, ah, yes, my mother was telling me about that all the time. I get it now.
Right.
I get it now. So,
he had to make it make sense for himself.
For himself.
Tell us why this role spoke to you.
Well, to be honest with you, I didn't know anything about FELA before I got the role. A friend of mine saw the show on Broadway and just said, I've just seen your next show. Melanie, I've just seen your next show. It's coming to London. Audition. This is it. Check it out on YouTube. And I looked on YouTube and all I saw was the first 5 minutes. And when you see the show, you will understand exactly what I mean. All you need to see is the first 5 minutes to be completely taken in and captured and excited. And it is my best role to date. I get to do absolutely everything in the show. Everything. I get to sing great songs. Because I'm dead, you hear me a lot backstage, and so I only appear five times on stage. But it's a very amazing role because I'm playing a real person, a real life person.
It sounds like it's been somewhat life-changing for you to be part of it.
It has. I mean, coming to America, for example, to come and play this role has been amazing, absolutely amazing. We've gone all over the country.
What can audience members learn about FELA and his life and the life of your character?
courage. Have that courage to believe in what you believe and to follow it through until the end. Always know that there is a light at the end of that tunnel. FELA was beaten, tortured, imprisoned over 200 times, and over 200 times he got up and said, well, I'm not dead yet. Let me write another song. Let me live another day. Let me just do what I need to do for these people. He had to be there. He had to be seen to be doing exactly what he said he was going to be doing, as opposed to, you know, going everywhere and perhaps getting the riches that he could have got.
So in a sense, it's a much needed message right now.
I think so. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And when they get there to watch the show, yes, it's a beautiful array of costumes, music, everything.
You will have a great time. I promise you, Baltimore, you will have a great time.
Come tell us where to see it and how long. Yeah, I think it's just at the... We'll have to actually put it at the bottom of your screen because you and I both are thinking about where is it?
Where is it?
Yeah, yes. We're going to put it at the bottom of the screen.
Okay.
And it's only a week long.
It's only
so
a week, yes.
So folks really have to...
Tuesday to Sunday, yes.
Get tickets, get out there and see it.
Please.
Sounds fantastic. Please. So nice to meet you.
And you. Thank you.
And I appreciate your description. It was beautiful.
Thank you.
Really was.